Can you hear, is it too loud?
We're good.
Okay. My name is Jonathan. I know Andy from, originally met Andy at ATUG, but now we ride MARTA together. So we're like really tight. I think we both were affected by a train delay yesterday, so it was, you know, got a little sweaty there.
It's terrible when you have to go downtown to go other towns.
Yeah. It's bad when they say, they get on the microphone and they say, the closest train is on the horizontal line when you're trying to go vertical.
Oh.
So, yeah. I work at 22 Square, I'm an analytics director, and I have a pretty quick presentation. Some background is we have a financial client, not SunTrust, another one called TIAA Bank, and this is for them. One of the things that we do pretty regularly is geographic prioritization for marketing. And so a lot of the times we want to understand where are we getting the most engagement. And typically, there's some kind of standard geographic fields in Tableau. And so that includes country, state, postal code, I think there's a few others. And there's some things you can do in terms of building, custom territories with polygons and things like that. But you can also apply a geographic role, which was a new learning for me. And so this is a quick example of how to do that, as well as we've kind of added in one of the new features from either 10.5 or 2018.1, the Viz and Tooltip feature, which is super easy and really cool, just from an exploratory data standpoint. So we'll talk about both of those, but before we do that, or before I walk you through it, I'll show you the end product, which is right here, and I'll show you the data set. So, let's look at this one. So this is a map of DMAs, which is a Nielsen term. Does anybody know what a DMA stands for? Defined market area. It's probably pretty close. I thought it was designated, but I'm actually not 100% sure. Designated. Bingo. So this is a map of relevant DMAs where we see search clicks or search engagement from Google for this client in particular. So one of the things this client did is they actually became a new brand, TIAA, which you may be familiar with. It's like a TIAA CREF. It's like a teacher/nonprofit retirement services. They wanted to get into banking for a long time, unsuccessfully, and so then they acquired a bank who was our client. So now we are kind of a sister company of TIAA. We are a TIAA bank. Used to be Everbank. Who owns Everbank Field, which is where the Jacksonville Jaguars play. Now it's TIAA Bank Field. It's really hard to say. So they actually invited, an entomologist or something to come in and say, do a write-up on how hard it was to say the new field name. It's kind of interesting. They're trying to understand with the launch of the new name who is engaging. So this is a map at the DMA level, which is kind of a Nielsen area where you might buy TV spots. So any sort of big play in terms of traditional media, you're going to buy at the DMA level. Typically, that's not always the case. So what you're looking at here is by density, the number of clicks. Not surprising here that Jacksonville, where the headquarters is really heavy. Miami down here, it's just a large population. I could change out clicks for cost per click. I found it really interesting that this is, I'm not gonna hover over it yet, but this is Panama City over here. And it is not what I would think to be the most expensive from a cost per click standpoint. So just kind of a side note. So one of the things to call out here is that I grouped zip codes up to the DMA level, and that's why you see some large buckets of territories. So we'll talk about that as we get into the video. And then secondly, I use this Vizen tooltip feature to, ask the question, where am I spiking within the DMA? Where am I seeing engagement down to the zip or postal code level? So that's how the Vizen tooltip feature works or looks like. I also did a variation of that with a bar chart. So we'll talk about that really quickly. Let's see. So I'm going to create a Matt, how do you write a chart on there?
Use that on the right side. Bottom right.
There you go. Okay. So, this is really easy. Let's look at the data set. So this is what the data looks like. Some of the work has already been done. Essentially, we have a partnership with Nielsen because we buy a lot of media and work with them. For that relationship, and so they regularly update a file in terms of mapping every zip code back to a designated market area. We combined that, we did a left join on that file with an export from DoubleClick. DoubleClick is the ads, Google's ad server, so if you're buying paid search for Google, you're doing it through DoubleClick most likely. We pulled the cost and the clicks out of DoubleClick by the zip code. That's what you see here. And then we calculated the cost per click. So all that's already been done. The cost per click is just that it's cost divided by clicks. You can see that here. So what I have here is a list of DMAs, and I have it by clicks. And, I can see some information visually, but I want to see it more geographically. So instead of going this route, I need to link the DMA down to the zip code. You can see that the data type for zip code by default is geographic, but this is being interpreted as a string of the ABC or a text dimension. So there's a cool feature that I learned about this past year called Geographic Role. And I'm going to go down to create from one of my existing fields that's geographic. I'm going to create a geographic role from the zip code. So now you can see that changed. Super easy. So now when I drag it out, it automatically knows that it's I'm looking for a map. I can change that to a field map, or instead, I can just look at, I can drop clicks on the color shelf and it automatically does that. So that's step one, super easy. So hopefully that's helpful if you're trying to have. Secondly, let me just duplicate this. And let's call this DNA and this zip. I can very simply just drag zip instead of DMA because I want to see the more detailed view. And now I have my zip map. And so the last thing here is the tooltip. And I just, what I did was go to worksheet, tooltip. I want to include my DMA name, my clicks. Maybe I want to include my CPC. Just for fun. I got it. Put it on the view. Go back. There you go. And now I'm going to insert, and there's this new feature in 10.5, I think, where you can select another sheet up at the top. And so I just created this zip tab. Bingo. I can customize a little bit. And this is interesting. I can filter the view based on what I've hovered over on the kind of master sheet. I'm going to keep all these kind of default settings that already exist. And now when I hover over Miami, I see the zips that pop within that DNA. So, any questions?
So how does it know that you're hovering over the DMA Miami and only show that? Like, what does the zip sheet show right now? It shows
zip sheet. The zip sheet right now is unfiltered.
Yeah. So what I'm asking is, how does it filter on all the zips that are within Miami?
Yeah, that's a great question. So when I pull up the tooltip, that's these default settings right here. There's this filter equals all fields. So essentially, what that's saying is, I want you to filter the underlying sheet by whatever's being hovered over us in the master sheet, parent sheet. I can take that out, I think, and then we can remove that setting, show the whole thing.
Also, you can, well, you said you didn't filter anything on zip, right? You said you didn't filter anything on zip, right? Correct?
I didn't filter anything on zip.
Go back to zip.
Okay.
Add filter that literally corresponds to what you just added.
It just created a filter. Okay. Yeah, that's a great point. Yeah. Learn something here. any other questions? Super simple. Unfortunately, I can't provide the DMA file. Like custom geocode? You can do that. It's kind of too, like, there's a lot of information on how to do that. Off the top of my head, I don't feel comfortable. Yeah, I don't have to do it. But yeah, there is, I think it's like map, geocoding, import custom geocoding. You have to have a file with, for example, we just did this recently. The client asked us, we have a list of hospital locations, and we have a list of where we plan to put billboards around these markets. Can you tell us if we have any gaps? And that required custom geocoding. So we had to upload a file of billboard name or hospital name, lab, and on. So you can definitely do stuff like that. It's a form of custom geocoding, maybe. It's done through this geographic role field. There, if you will remember from the underlying data, my file has a zip for every DNA. And so if that doesn't exist, I would have to, that's really more the custom geocode place, is where you don't have that relationship, parent-child, to a geographic field. You have to create that relationship. You have to tell Tableau, this is the last one of this specific thing. But Google it, because don't take my word for it. Any other questions?